Praise the Lord, my friends. I'm so glad to see what God is doing in the nation of Kenya. It's great to be back, and it's just the beginning of something new, that the fire of heaven is falling upon the people. I heard the Lord speak to me, and I did a broadcast on this like 2 days ago, that God is releasing a season of economy, an economic breakthrough. Economic breakthrough is coming for people, and you're going to see it. And the Lord said to me that He's not just releasing it for industry to be developed, for other people to do their thing, to swarm the market, because we see many foreign entities doing that from without and within, people that are not serving Jesus Christ. But I heard the Lord say, He said, tell the people that I want my house to be blessed. I want my sons and daughters to become entrepreneurs. I want my own children who are filled with my spirit, touched by me, my own elect. I want them to become millionaires and multimillionaires. The pastor shouted billionaires. Well, I like that too, but you have to start with million before you can get to billion. So I like to really practically zero in on the million number, because once you're flowing in some of that, you can then, you know, build onto another thing. You can't talk to someone that has nothing or a few thousand and tens of thousands about billion, practically speaking, although it's prophetic maybe. But I like to just concentrate, make your first goal to make a million. If it's a million shillings, one day it could become $1 million. And $1 million is 100 million shillings. That's a few shekels. Yeah, it's a few. It's not just about money in summation in the hands. It's also about the blessed life. And God wants to really empower people to break poverty. I want to say this. Poverty is of the devil. Prosperity is of God. And if you've ever said any word, I know a lot of people like to fall into the controversy, and the devil kind of tricks them up to begin to talk against this and that or for this and that. If you've ever said any word against financial increase, regardless, even if you don't understand it all or who's been doing what to get it, and if they're crooked, and then maybe you had some preachers that were greedy or filthy lucre, and they're all messed up, and people in the industry world, they're crooked devils, wicked people, and you don't understand that. But you know what, I want you to repent and apologize to God for ever speaking against it, because whatever you don't appreciate or honor really can't come into your life. And regardless of you understand it all or not, just say, Lord, I'm not going to allow myself to be a tool of the devil or deceived by the devil against what God wants to do in blessing me. So bravo to prosperity. It's not another gospel, regardless of what people say. And if some preachers have taken it too far and they do all these gimmicks and all this stuff and they're just about making money and all that, that's their problem. Please understand me, that is their business, it's their problem. God will sort it out and sort them out. But we are led not by what preachers do, or business people in the world, or industries, or corrupt politicians, or governments, or corrupt business people. We are led by the Word of God, by doctrine of the Bible. And every chapter in every book of the Bible, 1189 chapters, 66 books, written by more than 40 authors over 1500 years, over 850,000 words, okay? There are thousands of words in the Bible where God said He wants to financially enrich His people. And my God, I feel the anointing right now. And this is doctrine. This is from Jehovah to His own sons and daughters. So we need to take it as He said it and forget about everything else. You know, in my young age, I look younger than I am. People ask me my age. I refuse to tell them. And I was at a table in a conference in Springfield, Missouri, which is the head of the Assemblies of God area. We were right in the headquarters, Evangel University, the big hall, in the headquarters of the Assemblies of God. Imagine me being there. And we prophesied, my God, the power of God hit the place. And we were having a meeting, and people were asking me my age, and I refused to tell them. We made a joke about it. Do you know this one prophet, great prophet, dear friend of mine? he went to God and asked God what my age really was, and God told him, and he prophesied it. Now, I'm not going to tell you right now, but he said it over the microphone. He said, in the, and the number, year, in this year. And he said, God told him that to let me know that everything else that was being prophesied was really from God, because he spoke this amazing word over me, including things about the whole world being touched by our ministry and nations of the world. And thank God for beloved Kenya. I'm telling you, in Kenya first, and this is applicable to Uganda, Ethiopia, Rwanda, Tanzania, South Africa, Ghana, Nigeria. I could go on and on with the countries, and all of Europe, and all of America, the Americas, and all of the Far East, and all of the, you know, islands of the sea, nations of the world. And the Lord is speaking about economy. You could say, I received that. God is speaking about abundant and rich blessing. You could say, I received that. And the Lord is really, really on this. And you see, so, you see now everybody's talking about money and business, and some people think it's evil. It's not. God is also in the midst. And when you hear people make a controversy now that's happened of late, and it's really kind of sad, where people are saying that, you know, you shouldn't give like this and that. Don't let anybody tell you what you should give. If someone tells you not to sow $1,000 or give $1,000, I want to take that as a license. That now is the time I need to do it, because something's being stirred up here. Okay, and regardless of who it is and what man's opinion was or what someone's personal conviction is or philosophy, you're not to be led by that. We're to be led again by the word of God. And any miracle that God does, to him be all the glory, to him be all the praise. It's not by chance that there's such a wave of things and stirring about economy in this season that we're in right now. And take that as from, I'm telling you, you know, I prophesied Mwai Kibaki would be elected in 2002, re-elected in 2007. Uhuru Kenyatta would be elected in 2013. Everybody, some people said 2012. I never said 2012. It never came out of my mouth. And then when I look back at the transcripts later, I ended up saying 2013. I never said 2012. People were saying, what's going to happen in 2012? I said, well, I can't say the date. I didn't know why. Turns out there was a controversy about the election, and the election didn't really happen until 2013. God knew that. No man knew that. I never said what would happen in 2012 because it happened in 2013. But Uhuru Kenyatta was unanimously elected and then re-elected by a large margin in a double election. It was a really kind of tense thing. And then he won again because God wanted him to continue as the president. So, and things like 9/11, 4.5 years before, the Lord showed me an open vision, and I saw the buildings collapsing in New York. I saw the explosion. It was unbelievable. I mean, I was telling people they didn't even know what to think about it. I was on national television in the U.S., and God wouldn't even let me speak about it because it would have created so much of a stir, you know, regarding me. God wanted to spare me of all of that. So all of these world events and the superhighway, the Thika superhighway, and all the road development that's going on, all of these things God had me prophesy before. I'm the same prophet, and I'm telling you again, right now, in advance, that this is a season of economy, economic breakthrough, financial increase, and it's for you, God's own son and daughter, God's own son, God's own daughter, to take this for your own life.
Amen.
And cast out every impoverished way of thinking, every hatred of the rich, even hatred of the corrupt. You know, nobody likes a corrupt person. They're a thief. They deserve to be. But don't get bitter about it. As I was saying, I was talking about age. In my young age, all right, I don't want to belabor the point. People ask me my age. I say, well, I'm younger than Methuselah, but a little older than a millennial, somewhere in between. Methuselah lived to 969. A millennial is only like 18 years old. So I'm somewhere in between. I won't tell you exactly where. But in my young age, I'm kind of feeling like to leave some things alone, to leave some people alone, to be loving to people that are not even that good of a person, somehow. Now, some people are under God's judgment. I got to stay straight with this. Some people are under God's judgment, and it's not coming off because of the horrible things they've done have offended God, and God says, I'm judging them. Now, that's another issue. But some people are just messed up and tripped up, and I think we need more grace to be able to just love and communicate and kind of be friendly with a lot of people. I'm feeling peace about that right now. Not to be so hot-headed about, you know, well, you're wrong and you're right, you know what I mean? Which is there, but I feel a little bit of grace to just be like able to tolerate, I don't even like the word, to be able to coexist peaceably with people. And hopefully God, you know, God's going to get in the midst and change a lot of people's ways, and we trust God for that. But thus saith the Lord, again, to the nation of Kenya and beyond to the whole world, this is a season of economic advancement. And if you need financial healing, financial breakthrough, financial increase, I want you to lift your hand right now, and I just want to speak this word over you, that God's going to begin to bless you in ways you've not seen. He's going to connect you with people you never knew you'd be connected with. He's going to set up divine networks, connections, and give you brilliant ideas and brilliant wisdom on how to do business, how to do your ministry, how to do business, how to advance in your career so that you can be blessed. And why, if you would ask, why should we be blessed? So that you can advance the kingdom of God. You know what? You could buy a Mercedes, I've done it, cash, and you could enjoy a few nice things, but after a while you get tired of that. You know, money is not to be flashy. It's not the purpose of it is not to be flashy and put your shoulders up and say, look at me. Nice things can make you feel good. I'm all for that. By the way, let me just tell you my position. I am 100% for prosperity. In fact, I've taken a vow of prosperity before the Lord, not a vow of poverty, never. We are called and chosen by God to be rich, not poor. No apology about that. And that's actually biblical in its source, formation, and manifestation and fruition now. But money gives you options to bless people. How would you like to be able to bless somebody? Help hurting people in the world. That's advancing the kingdom of God, and God does want to give you the wealth and the treasure so that you can do that, but also to enjoy your life, also to have nice things, also to own your house, not to rent from somebody else, also to buy a car and pay it off and not have loans at high interest to the bank here in Africa. The banks, high interest. And man, if you don't pay them, how mean they can get. Some of you can say big amen to that. They're ruthless and cruel, and they can smile at you one day, but go late on a payment. Oh, you see how they change quick and come back at you. You don't want that. You want to be flush, blessed. I mean flush, like everything is in the green, in the profit zone, in the no debt zone, in the assets, not liabilities, including owning real estate. And this is the word of the Lord. It's a season of economy. It's a season of breakthrough. Father, I pray and I declare and I prophesy to my friend watching right now that you're going to cause your favor, your face to shine upon them, that they'll come out of the situations they've been in and rise now to an entirely different, new, higher level of manifestation of your blessings in this season of time in their life, in Jesus' name. And if you need healing in your body, I curse the disease. As our bishop was saying here, we curse those diseases and ailments, and they die now. Oppression of the devil, it goes off of you now. Poverty, it leaves your house now. And prosperity and the blessings of God come in. One thing you need to know also, if you're going to receive anything, you need to be proud of it, happy about it, honorable toward it, and shout it from the housetops without apology. I think a lot of pastors, they don't talk about money because they're afraid the people might get mad, or some people have misused the principle. And I think that's what the controversy in the church that's been going on is, kind of over that. And if someone got a bad taste or they have a personal opinion about it, leave it to them and don't take it as your own. You get back in the Bible and read it and also declare. And I prophesy also that many leaders, and I want to lay my hands on them and touch them, pastors, evangelists, prophets, apostles, teachers are going to be raised up by God to teach the laws of the kingdom and the laws of biblical economics and the laws of biblical blessing, and that the people can know and understand and take action so that they and their houses can be blessed. The Bible also says in, I can't remember the exact verse, I think it's Ezekiel 44:30, yeah, that you should bring the gift to the priest. What does that mean? Abraham gave the tithe to Melchizedek, and he was blessed beyond measure. You need to be a tither, you need to be a giver. You need to honor the man of God in your life, the servant of God who's feeding you. You need to honor them with your substance, and then that seed produces then a harvest. So take action accordingly. Of course, our website is thomasmanton.com. You can connect with us there and also on the social media, Facebook, Instagram, Periscope, Twitter, which we're doing some of that. Also, but Facebook, facebook.com/ThomasManton or /Dr. for Dr. Thomas Manton. I'll see you there. And on our website, there's a comment section. You can write a note and please do put your phone number and say hi to us and we'll be able to communicate back and forth. Let me give you a phone number to WhatsApp or to use for M-Pesa or whatever to send messages. Is in Kenya is +254-792-320-780, and that will be on the screen. And also, of course, you can email us, you can contact us on the social media. I love you so much. I am praying for the manifestation of the blessings of God more than you've ever known in your life to come upon you and your house now, and your houses and your churches and the people of God in Jesus' name. I'm Thomas Manton IV. More later. Love you much. Talk to you real soon. Praying for you.